In this video, we're going to tell you 7 reasons why you should not get a chocolate lab. Chocolate labs are beautiful, they're loving, loyal, and they are friendly, but they may not be for everyone. And in this video, we'll tell you 7 reasons why. If you're new to our channel, welcome. We make dog videos that are educational and entertaining. So if you love dogs, consider subscribing. And by the end of this video, you'll know if a chocolate lab is right for you and if you as the owner can handle them and if they make a good fit for you and your family. So let's get the countdown started with number 1. The first reason that a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because of their exercise requirements. These guys need exercise, and if they get exercise, they're great dogs. If they don't, they can be very destructive. So if you don't have the time or energy to give them the exercise they need, then a chocolate lab may not be best for you. They don't want to be just let out in the backyard. They want to play, run, swim, do whatever it is that you're doing as the owner. They want to get rid of all that pent-up energy inside of them, and they want to hang out with their owner and build that bond as well. So they want to play fetch, go for a walk. They just want to be with you. If you're not willing to do that or don't have the time or energy to do it, then a chocolate lab is not for you. The number 2 reason why a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because they need to be socialized early and often. So if you don't have the ability to get them around other people, other dogs, other animals, then a chocolate lab just isn't for you. Because these guys can be great if they're socialized. They want to be held by humans. They want to be around chickens, dogs, donkeys. It doesn't matter. These guys can be friendly and loving to so many people if they get the opportunity. But if you as the owner don't get them around people, then they can be dangerous, have high anxiety around people, and they're just going to lash out because they've never been around people. This is a big dog, and if they can get around people, they'll be loving and gentle, and you won't have to worry. But if you can't, then a chocolate lab just isn't for you. The third reason why a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because they shed a lot. They actually shed more than people realize. Because they don't have long coats, you may think that there's not a lot of hair, but you will definitely find hair on your clothes, on your furniture, on your floor. So if you don't like shedding, then a chocolate lab's not gonna be for you. But if you know that the shedding's coming and are able to give them some regular brushings, then the shedding's not too bad and can be managed. But if you think these guys aren't gonna shed too much, then you're really wrong and you'll be really disappointed, and it may not be best for you to get a chocolate lab. The fourth reason why a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because of separation anxiety. These guys want to be around their owner as much as possible. So if you're gonna be an owner that has a job where you're gone most of the day or something else takes you away from these dogs for the majority of the day, then a chocolate lab is not gonna be for you. They wanna be around their owner. They wanna be pleasing their owner. They want a job to do. They wanna fetch. They wanna be pet. They wanna be super active, and they wanna be around their owner as much as possible. So if you're not around most of the day, then a chocolate lab's not gonna be for you, because by the time you get home, give them the exercise that they need, it's just not gonna be enough throughout the day. The fifth reason a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because of their size. They get pretty big. Don't be fooled when you get that cute little chocolate lab puppy. Just know that they're gonna get big, anywhere up to 100 to 125 pounds in some cases. This is a big, strong, yet gentle dog. But just know that if you have kids or if you're a little bit older and you're gonna take this dog for a walk, unless they're trained, unless they're ready, they can be a handful because they're big, they're strong, and they're powerful. And so just know that if you can't handle the strength and size of a chocolate lab, then maybe this dog is not for you. The sixth reason why a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because they need a strong leader that's calm, assertive. This dog needs direction, it needs training, and it looks to its leader. This is a dog that's an old hunting dog and wants direction, wants a job. So as the owner, it's up to you to be calm, assertive, and confident. So if this is your first dog or you're not comfortable around dogs, maybe a chocolate lab's not for you. But if you know what you're doing and you want a dog that you can train and lead, then a chocolate lab is perfect. They really have a gentle nature and they really are great dogs, but they need just a little bit of training early on, socialization and exercise, and they can be a perfect dog. The last reason why a chocolate lab may not be best for you is because of their curiosity. These guys have an incredible nose, and they'll use that nose to get into trouble, get into mischief, and misbehave from time to time. They're old hunting dogs that want to look for things, want to be out and about and adventurous. So if you don't give them boundaries, rules, limitations early on, this dog could be a handful for you. So just know that they need a little training early on. They need to be socialized, they need exercise, and they need a strong leader that can give them the training necessary right from the beginning. If you do that, a chocolate lab will be perfect for you and one that you'll love for years to come. We hope you've enjoyed this video all about the chocolate lab, and we'll see you on the next one.